What is good, friends? I'm here with Pukim vs. Assyrian's Grace for World Cup qualifying. And Aim pretty much has to pick up the win for his team, because they are in the back. And I'm not really sure how loud I can speak. There are people sleeping, it's really early in the morning. And I'm also still kind of half asleep. But yeah, I woke up 30 minutes ago. Started uploading the games that I recorded yesterday late at night or in the evening. And yeah, I hope you guys appreciate the effort that I put in here. And we see Pokémon bring this team that I think Blunder brought this to Smoven Tour, which is a defensive default Mew with Solvest, Tangrowth. I don't remember 100%, but I think it was Scarf Latios. Was just making sure that I was playing music. I think it was Scarf Latios and Bandit Zygarde and Ash Greninja, if I recall correctly. And then it could be Xenoph Majorna. And on Assyrian's Grace team, it looks pretty cool. They have both have bulky offense. Yeah, two of the same ones. Actually, Latios plus Zygarde is also like a core that I use a lot myself. I mean, Scarf Latios and Bandit Zygarde, or like. Yeah, that's like a combination I use a lot. Mega Principles, Tapu Blue. Let me just see. So on this team, I think it's Scarf Kelly because it's one of the best Greninja checks. I was talking about Scarf Latios, but that's just about the core in general. I think this Latios is either Specs or Soldier or Z-Move. I mean, yeah, that's a lot of options, but looking at the team, Rockstrain obviously. Z-Move Tapu Blue makes a little bit more sense, so Life Orb Sildu or Specs could be an option here. Z-Move can also be on the DD Zygarde, but I assume it's gonna be banned Zygarde. And that's a really cool lead for him. He can predict. I don't remember if this Mew has knockoff. I think it had Psychic, Will-O-Wisp, Defog, and Rocks. So yeah, he just goes for the Rocks, because there was no way he'd just go for Will-O-Wisp when there's a Heatran in the back. And gets up the Rocks turn 1 for free, pretty much. It's a good start for him. And yeah, the Heatran can throw out a Toxic, predicting something like Zygarde, or it can go for his own Rocks. Yeah, throws up his own Rocks. And if this is Bandit, he doesn't have the best switch-ins, especially because his Tapu Bulu is most likely offensive. And yeah, Bandit's Thousand Arrows will still do a lot, and if Aim gets the prediction correct and goes for Iron Tail, it will blow the Tapu Bulu away. He doesn't have a reason to not click Thousand Arrows. He pretty much doesn't lose much from clicking it. It's just a spammable move. It also doesn't get nerfed by the grassy terrain because of yeah, that's how it works. Grassy terrain only nerfs Earthquake, and maybe that's a second move, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't nerf Thousand Arrows. So yeah, I assume we're gonna see the type of blue switch, and Thousand Arrows plus Stealth Rocks will do like 45, maybe 50%, and then we will heal a little bit back with grassy terrain. If he goes for Iron Tail, it's gonna be a good play, but he doesn't have to make the play, like I said. Yeah, pretty much what I expected. I expected a little bit more damage, to be honest. I thought it would bring it down to like half. But yeah, he got the grassy terrain covering him up, giving him some health, and now I assume we're gonna see the Tangrowth slash Majuna slash Mew come out. The Tangrowth is probably going to be like HP Ice, the standard Solvest 7, knockoff Earthquake, Hidden Power Ice, knockoff. Did I always say that? I think I forgot the fourth move slot. I don't think they carry Sludge Bomb anymore at the moment. Majuna is a nice win condition late game if he gets up a Shift Gear. Don't remember if he has Focus Blast to hit Heatran, but like he pretty much can go through his team with Bolt Beam plus Focus Blast late game. Aim decides to stay in, maybe predicting an aggressive double switch from Simon Grace's part. But he just gets some damage on the top. Bulu, it doesn't tweet KO though. We saw the 32 twice. I'm pretty sure there's no way it gets like a higher roll on kills. But he does just stay in, and Hornleech is gonna give him a lot of health back here, so I'm not really sure if staying in with Zygarde was the play there. Yeah, this type of Bulu is getting one kill, that's like my boy BTB said here in the chat. And aggressive terrain ended, so it's only at 44%, but Since Graves gets rid of the Zygarde, which... So basically Aim used the Zygarde to weaken the top of Bulu, but... I'm still thinking if he predicted a double there, or if he just wanted damage on the Bulu. Because maybe he just wanted damage on the Bulu and set up Mjuna later, but the thing is he can't really set up... Yeah. Like, if he can set up Mjuna, it's not now, because this Tapu Bulu is threatening him with a Z-move, basically. So he's forced out into Greninja slash Latios here. I mean, if he's fast Mew, he can also go Mew, but Greninja makes the most sense. And I assume we're going to see an Ice Beam slash Hydro Pump come out here from the Ash Greninja Battle Bond formation, unless he changed it. I mean, it's not in Ash form yet, but he's going to try to get into that form. And I assume we're going to see the Keldeo switch from Searing Grace's side to not give this Greninja the Battle Bond, as that would make the most sense to me. You don't just want to give this monster the form change. Tapu Bulu is not going to put in too much more work, let's be honest, after you switch it out and lose the Sword Stance boost. But it's still kind of important to not give the Greninja the form, in my opinion. Yeah, Water Shuriken in late game would be deadly if he gives him the Ash form. They're both timers are kind of running down, but like if I'm aim, I probably click a Hydro Pump. It's a bit risky because it can miss, but it does. It should kill the Tapu Bulu, and if it's the Specs Greninja that I assume it is, and it should do a lot to Keldeo. And he goes Heatran, which is a really weird question to play. Questionable. He gets blown away by the Hydro Pump. So I'm sorry if I like offended you guy, but I probably that was weird. Like he obviously predicted Ice Beam. But AIM had... I think Hydro Pump was AIM's best play, in my opinion. Someone has said... Did someone in the chat, like, the Ghost or something, or mentioned the play? He said, like, they said, like, Ben, I didn't really pay attention to this chat. I'm really just trying to figure out this... And yeah, like I said, like, Hydro Pump was fine for him, besides the risk of missing. And I can completely agree with Tidering there, because, like, in case he wanted to go Heatran, trying to go Heatran on Ice Beam, he got blown away. I don't know why he wouldn't go Keldeo there, like, that was really questionable, I feel. Yeah. So the Keldeo is in, and it's a Scarf Keldeo, and it's gonna double out written the Mew slash Tangrowth. The Tapu Bulu. We see a Mew gets Grassy Turn first, so it's gonna be fast Mew, and he has a free Will-O-Wisp, so this game is pretty much in AIM's favor, and... Searing Grace would have been in an okay position if he just went into... Latios was too risky, I guess, I can agree, because he could've... You'd never know if he would've Ice Beam or Dark Pulse there. Those Dark Pulse might actually kill Bulu from 44, because it's kind of rare, but so yeah... Keldeo was definitely the play the last turn. I mean, yeah, Keldeo still takes a lot from Specs Pump and Rocks, but he had to make that play, like I explained earlier, not to not give the Greninja the form and to, like, stay in the game, I feel. So now it's just gonna be really tough. If this mutes this Will-O-Wisp, it's pretty much over for Searing Grace. Like, I can, like, try to... Yeah, that does absolutely nothing. And AIM can just spam Will-O-Wisp or Psychic here. He's probably just gonna click Psychic. I mean, his win condition now is basically maybe Pinsir getting up an SD, but the problem, and Zygarde clicking E-Speed late game weakening stuff, but the problem is that's not gonna work out. He goes hard on the Zygarde. I mean, yeah, AIM could have double whisked, but he didn't have to, so this is fine. But the Zygarde, if it's... It's faster than the Mew, yeah, but he gets the Mew poison, but this Mew pretty much has the damage done to your team, yeah. So he's banned in the Toxic, so this is a free Mjolnir, and then he can shift gear up and pretty much clear the game from there. I don't see how Pokémon can lose this, and I know he's a good player and he won't choke this away. I mean, he can also stay in and sack this Mew, it's completely fine. Like, the only way I could see Searing Grace winning, I wanted to say, but maybe Pinsir could put in some work, but Pinsir won't win, because even if Pinsir gets an SD and potentially kills, can kill Greninja with that, A water shuriken after rocks will just do a lot to Pinsir. We can run the Kulk really quick, as I assume he's just gonna click a Draco with his Lati or... it is pretty much a free tank growth for him, I think. But yeah, I do wanna run the Kulk for you guys between Trotspecs, Greninja and Mega Pinsir to see if Pinsir can win. As water shuriken does 66 to 79, so after Stealthrocks, it pretty much almost kills. He doubled into Zygarde, predicting the Majorna, I assume. So that's an okay play, yeah. He's trying to fight back. I mean, it works out, the Mew stayed in. Aim's probably just trying to sack this Mew, get a free switch into his Majorna, get a shift gear up. Like, Pinsir would need an SD to kill a Majorna with an Earthquake, because like as you see, offensive shift key Majorna takes an Earthquake. It does like 73 to 87, so that still is a lot. But Aim just has so many win conditions at this point. Late game Water Shuriken, it just has to weaken the Kelly a little bit more for late game Water Shuriken. And I mean, yeah, the Latias also, but the Latias is kept in check by Tangrowth plus Majorna, like... I mean, Aim played this fine for the most part. I still don't know how I feel about staying with the Zygarde on the Bulu earlier, but it definitely worked out. Because he basically weakened the Tapu Bulu into range where his Ash Greninja could kill it. And that helped him get off the Ash form, even though, like I said, he should have never allowed that and gone to Kelio. Even if Aim pulled out the extra sensory, that wouldn't kill the Kelio. As he goes into Tangrowth, makes a safe play, doesn't lose anything from doing it. Even if he went for Outreach there, Aim just had a free... switch into Majorna into on the next turn or sack off his Mew, predicting Siren's Grace to double into something. Like, sacking Mew always gives Aim momentum back if he ever needs to, and combination of what I assume Scarf Lati plus Water Shuriken or just Specs Greninja spamming Dark Pulse weakening the Scarf Keldeo because it has to come in maybe. Now the next time a Greninja comes in, you can sack the Tapu Bulu, but like you guys can see, right, these three mons plus the backup AV Tangrowth, like Aim is just in such a good position, especially with the Tapu Bulu being burned and the Zygarde being poisoned is pretty clutch, the Zygarde being low. Zygarde will have to predict a lot, and it's like tough, because like I said, if he looks in the outreach, Majorna gets a free switch in, and Majorna is so scary. If it gets up a shift gear, pretty much cleans up his opponent too. And yeah, this Latias is gonna... I mean, he didn't go for Z-move yet with Bulu, but I'm really assuming his Z-move Bulu either sub-SD or just SD3 attacks. Also, Leech Seed is another option. But yeah, Lati is probably gonna go for Draco, yeah. Oh, he goes for Roost, okay. Because I don't think Aim will ever go hard into Majorna. The thing is, if he goes for Draco and kills something, the Majorna just wins from there, so maybe that's not the play. But no matter how much I think, I don't really see an out for Siren's Grace, because Aim is just in such a good position that he can always try to sack his Mew, and then if he gets his Majorna in on Tapu Bulu, which is burned, or on Latios, which can't really touch it, and he gets a shift gear up, and he's outside of range, like Scarf Kelly might outspeed shift gear Majorna, right? He goes for Defog, but Aim is just gonna get the rocks back up, like... That play didn't accomplish anything, because, yeah, okay, unless he kills the Mew here, then he got rid of the rocks, but that doesn't do much, like, I mean, yes, okay, let's not talk too much downer. He got rid of the rocks for his Pinsir, which is understandable, right? But if he wants to kill the Mew here, I think he has to go for Draco, and that would give the Majorna a free setup. So yeah, and just gets the rocks back up. Okay, but this is his only chance, to win. Oh my lord, he played this expertly. So, the thing is, the Mew's just gonna click Will-O-Wisp. So unless it's a fast substitute Pinsir, unless it's substitute Pinsir, this is not gonna work out for Siren's Grace. If it's sub-SD, it's actually Savage Beast Threat, but the Majorna would still check it. Oh, Aim turn off the timer, that's pretty nice. I mean, that was played well, because he got in the Pinsir before rocks, but he's still forced to attack here. Yeah, he's forced to attack. Aim's best play is still clicking Psychic, as it would probably put the pincer in range to dive from a water shuriken. Slash, yeah, Ladi also kills this with Draco, but you always can miss a Draco, so spamming Psychic would just ensure that this doesn't get up a sub randomly and, like, become, like, a problem randomly. Like, I'm just trying to think of some options where Season's Grace could somehow win. I mean, that was actually a good play on him. I don't want to talk down. Good play, my guy. Getting the pincer before rocks and getting rid of the Mew, but the Ladi slash Magearna can come out now. And, like, if Aim goes in the Latios, he would probably sack off the Tapu Bulu. The thing is, this pincer is gonna be forced out by either by the Magearna or by the Ladi. So, by Ladi would have been forced out, but versus Magearna, I think he has to stay in an Earthquake because he needs damage on a Magearna. As Aim is gonna go for a Shift Gear here, I assume. I do want to do the Kalk if Magearna outspeeds Scarf Kellio, by the way. Because I'm not 100% sure about that. It hits 502 if it's max speed, and Kellio hits 346 plus 1.5. It's early in the morning, guys. Let me grab my calculator. Nice and professional. 346. 1.5 is a 519. So Scarf Kellio hits more speed than a Magearna, if I'm not mistaken here. As Magearna hits 502. Yeah. So you can click Earthquake here, right? Earthquake should do like 70 or 80. We have done the Kulk earlier. Pincer Mega. Earthquake does 73 to 87. So yeah, that's basically his play. Clicking Earthquake, weakening the Magearna. And yeah, since I saw that the Scarf Kellio outspeeds the Magearna anyways, I really hope I didn't calc anything wrong, but I should be okay. The only reason why I'm still questioning myself is because it's like early in the morning. And maybe I can't think clear, but I feel like I've done a decent job so much. And yeah, it's actually kind of better for me sometimes when I record alone, because, like, man, these white people. I mean, Padlop is cool and everything, but sometimes he just goes insane mode and doesn't let me talk in my own video. He makes the Earthquake play, and I think Aim's just gonna attack. Exactly, brings the pincer in range where it dies from rocks, makes the pincer stay in, basically. But he had to Earthquake, not giving the Magearna free setup or just getting damage on it. But now he dealt the damage to the pincer, pretty much, and Aim's Scarf Latios is looking to be pretty much cleaning up this late game. Like, it's looking in such a good position for Aim. Yeah, you just click return slash frustration, whatever it's called. Yeah, return. Like, whatever he has. Okay, so now he's gonna go in Latios or Greninja. Greninja would be a play if he doesn't want to take any quick attack damage on his Latios. Yeah, he actually, Serene's Grace actually played that decently well. The thing is, Aim is like back in the score now, so you might think he turned it around, but I think Aim still has the game. Because he just set up the game with. He had to turn the timer. This timer is unclicked, I'm dying. Oh, he's at 30 seconds, so he turned him off again. So, pretty much, Aim did it so Scarflight can clean late game. I mean, Zygarde still has E speed, but there's no rocks in Aim side. Latios at full. The Tapu Bulu is burned. So, like, Aim pretty much can win with just clicking a psychic move if he gets rid of the opposing Latios. So, that's gonna be interesting how this plays out in the late game. I think Aim still has it, but don't want to speak too soon, as I assume he's just. Okay, just goes for Dark Pulse. I thought. Yeah, that actually makes sense. In case Serene's Grace, like, predicted Water Shuriken went hard into Ladi for some reason. Also, it did more damage to the Kellio. This is a bit confusing because I mean, yeah, the Tapu Bulu wasn't doing much. It was just fodder, but the Pinsir also dies to rock, so that's... Oh, yeah, he can still defog. Yeah, he can still defog, I guess. So, the thing is, he can never really get the opportunity to defog with anything, because his Latios... Unless his aim's Latios locked into a psychic move, then Sirius Grace can defog. But other than that, I don't really see... And if he... Okay, so Scarf Kellio is in. This is a pretty obvious Tangrowth. Yeah, the Tangrowth in the back is just so nice for him. The Tangrowth plus the Scarf Lady should have this. Like, I might be wrong sometimes, but I don't think I'm in the wrong here. Yeah, I can understand that he's nervous and he's taking like his time. I would be nervous too, like, even if I would just play aim on the ladder. I did play him once on the ladder, and my looking back at my video narration, that was not the best narration, even though it was post-narrated. Yeah, this is tough. I'm pretty sure aim will just go into his Tangrowth here, especially... Sacking the Tapu Bulu also give aim the grassy terrain, which helps his Tangrowth to get a switch easily onto Kellia. What else? Can he afford to make a double here? I think he kinda has to. The thing is he can't really make a double that pressures the Tangrowth. That's the problem here. Yeah, he cannot really pressure the Tangrowth. Like, the Tangrowth itself at 69, but I think it's pretty much at full, because Regenerator isn't cocked in yet. I think that's how Shuriken works, right? Yeah, so this is pretty bad for Seeing's Grace. If he Secret Swords, the Tangrowth comes in, gets Gracie turned back. And the only double that I could think of would be Zygarde and trying to Toxic the Tangrowth, because then it would get consistent chip damage. The thing is, Toxicing the Tangrowth, it's nice for chip, but I don't think it would win him the game. Because let's say he doubles into Tangrowth, into Zygarde, he breaking the Tangrowth, and he gets the Toxic off in the Tangrowth. His Zygarde then dies to Gigadin slash HP Ice. And then he's still in a bad position. Okay, aim makes the Kellio play. I didn't even think about the Latios play. I didn't even think about the Latios play. I just saw that Tangrowth covered all options. Because he had Grassy Terrain up, so he would get more health back. One, two, like, Kellio can't really do anything to Tangrowth, you know, it's pretty much Scarf Kellio. Three, he can't double into Pinsir to pressure your Tangrowth because it's, it dies to rocks. This was still a fine play, I'm not trying to attack, aim down or anything, but I just personally would have made the Tangrowth play. Maybe I make the wrong play, that's just how I would have played this. And he misses a Draco Meteor, so it begins. It's not over yet, it's Pokemon. If you know, I'm pretty sure aim will just go out into... Actually no, aim, this is risky for aim. Because if he goes out into Tangrowth and he goes for Outrage here, his Tangrowth will get 2-hit KO'd and he has to sack something. So yeah, I think he has to risk another Draco here. Because it just... You have to, like, consider, he already missed one Draco, I don't think he will miss another one, like... Like, just if you aim and you switch out here into Tangrowth and he goes for Outrage. Like, yeah, if you go... Oh, he goes for E-Speed, okay. But if he gets damage off, which is really cool for Siren's Grace, because it's on Scarf Kellio range now and it's at minus 2, so Kellio can eat a Draco up. But on the other side, I think maybe going for the Choke would have been the play. Nah, E-Speed... I guess E-Speed would have been fine, because if he could have gone for the crit, yeah... He could have gone for the crit, and the Lali pretty much had to stay in there. It's a little bit tough to, like, get every analyze correct. I'm pretty sure, like, some are wrong. But, yeah, hope you guys appreciate me bringing this live. Do you aim? Actually, not sure if aim is recording his game live. He might be. But he knows the Kellio can take a minus 2 Draco with ease. And this is the freest Tangrowth for aim I've ever seen. He wants to keep the Scarf Lali. And, yeah, like I said, I would have made this Tangrowth play earlier, but it's completely fine, like... Like you guys saw, right? I mean, I can understand he missed the Draco. I can understand why he made the play, because Tangrowth is the only one that allows the Latios on Theomgrain's side to get off the defog. Kind of, but it still pressures it out with knockoff. Like knockoff still does a ton of damage to it. Tengu still takes a hit from Latian as it gets crit. And maybe it even takes, actually I don't think it takes it crit Draco. Unless from 4, maybe from 4. Nah, from 4 maybe not. Yeah, from 4 probably not. Draco crit, it might be a different story. But yeah, this is pretty much aim just clicking Giga Drain on knockoff, getting rid of the scarf. So now his Greninja beats this, and the Keldeo doesn't do enough damage. I think he bricked the Latios there, which is a fair play. He didn't have to make the play, but I can understand the play for sure. So he's just gonna click. This is a bit tough, because I think Theomgrace has to go into Latios and bank on aim going for Giga Drain here. But yeah, the thing is, even if he gets the defog off, like I mentioned earlier, yes, Lati would have gotten potentially a defog on Tangrowth, but what would you gain from getting the defog on Tangrowth off? You would get knocked off if he stays in, and your Pinsir dies to Water Shuriken, and your Pinsir gets outsped by Lati anyway, so yeah. Like, I think his win condition at this point is like some sort of hacks. This game is looking actually really close, but I think aim was still in control for most of it. Yeah, he does make the safe Giga Drain play. I think he had to go into Latios there banking on the Giga Drain, but I can completely understand aim as he's making the Lord plays, getting rid of the soldier. Yeah, I mean, yeah, he gets the rocks off and Pinsir gets another kill here, but aim played this pretty well, I feel, at the end. I would have only made the one play different, where I would have gone Tangrowth instead of Lati, but definitely, probably will have a good reason that he will explain to you guys in his narration, if he will upload that. What else? I mean, I'm just really like World Cup coverage live, and you guys probably like it too, as he's just gonna click Dark Pulse here. I mean, yeah, he can click Water Shuriken, it doesn't matter. Water Shuriken is, I guess, the better play, because you don't risk, like, a quick attack, max roll crit. But yeah, I forgot the Keldeo was at 18. If the Keldeo was at 18, that obviously was fine. I thought he would have to go for something like Dark Pulse to kill the Keldeo for sure, but I mean, he had the Scarf Light in the back anyway to clear the game. But yeah, that was a cool game, definitely. I liked this a little bit more than some of the other games that we had so far. And was definitely kind of close, but yeah, like I said, I feel aim was in the control pretty much for most of the game, besides at the beginning the SD Tabu Bulu was a little bit threatening. But yeah, I mean, I was questioning the play at first with Zygarde staying in on the Bulu, but I think looking back at it was a cool play, weakening the Tabu Bulu into range from Ash Greninja. Pretty much already mentioned everything. I might have lost my train of thought, my thought process, like here and there, I might have like gone off a bit, but it should be fine overall. I thank you guys for watching, and yeah, the score should be a 3-2 now between US Metro and India. So India is still in the lead with my man BTB, and yeah, we can have a look here. Obi's playing later with Blimex for Sun and Moon OU. That's pretty much the game that I'm going to be bringing you. I might not bring you DPP in Black and White, only if it comes down to these games. I'll look up at the schedule which games play first. I think the OB games play first. And yeah, also, like you saw in my last upload, if you saw it already, Latin America won 5-2 versus Bangladesh, so they are in a World Cup. And my man Uzi Gunner, and like, I know him a bit, so he's like trying to make a name for himself, kind of, so he might still play versus all cons. We will see what happens here. Even though the game doesn't matter, they might still play. So I might record that if they play. But anyways, I thank you guys for watching. This was a really cool game. I love this type of bulky offense or balance. Yeah, more bulky offense, I would say, yeah. And yeah, stay tuned for more World Cup coverage. And yeah, Dokuch signing out. Peace. Have a good day.